if you don't trust random photographers, stay cool and explain you just don't want them to do it and that it's your private property. Burglars also might stage some accident just to lure you out of your house. A fake utility worker can claim there's a gas or water leak. You leave the room for a couple of minutes, but it's already too late. An experienced burglar can get what they need in as little as 90 seconds. Always validate the identity of strangers showing up like this. Just call your utility provider. Beware if you see some sticker or paint on your door. Sure, these could be just coincidental nuisances, but it can also be a sign that someone wants to mark your house and set it apart from the rest. Get rid of it as soon as you can. Burglars can leave marks, and so can you. To find out if you've had some unexpected visitors scoping the place out, leave some cookies under your welcome mat. If someone comes up to check where you are, they'll crush them. It's a crummy trick. Your doorbell rings, you answer it, and nobody's on the other side. Before you blame those neighborhood pranksters again, consider this. Someone could be checking to see if you're home. Same goes for any strange calls you get with nobody on the other line. If you still have a home phone, that is. On that note, don't just open the door at any knock or ring. Verify who's on the other side first. If they say they're from your utility company, rental office, or city services, ask them for ID and call the company to get it checked. Even if you have a video doorbell. Anybody can buy a uniform these days. Don't go based on looks alone. A seemingly innocent flyer or ad under the doormat can also mean your house is a target. If it's still there the next day, it can make burglars think that nobody's home. Any person who finds some junk mail under their feet will throw it away, right? Speaking of junk mail, sometimes we're just too lazy or absent-minded to collect it. But too much mail in the box or a pile of old newspapers on the porch send one message: this homeowner is away and has been out for a while. If you really are away, don't forget to stop your mail delivery. Be careful when you sell your car or any other big price items. Delete the ads you posted as soon as you sell it. Many burglars call and pretend to be interested, asking if you still have it. Saying, "No, sold it already," will let them know you've just gotten a lot of money. Even if you spent it already, this person might like to break in and find out for themselves. Be sure to keep your shrubbery trimmed and your lawn nice and neat. One, others will know you're home and taking care of the outdoor chores. And two, overgrown bushes make a great hiding place for intruders. If you'll be gone on vacation, have someone take care of your lawn for you. 85% of home invasions happen through a door. A burglar prefers it to a window because they're afraid of leaving DNA traces. If they're hopping through a window, chances are too high they'll get cut. Even a single drop of blood is enough to solve the case. If your car keys are attached to the same ring, that's even worse. The burglar can load all the stuff they've just stolen into your car and get away in less than a minute. That's how quick the average burglary happens. So, no keys in the door. Got it. But don't even leave them near the door. I'm talking about hanging hooks or a bowl on the table many of us have right next to the front door. You throw your keys, wallet, and maybe some cash in there nonchalantly as soon as you walk in. Get rid of those and store all that stuff in a safe place away from the door. Phishing-style key thefts are on the rise. Be especially aware if you have a mail slot in your door. These phishers can slip a coat hanger in there, grab the keys with the hook at the end, and pull them through the slot if your key set isn't too bulky. Well then, I'll just keep a bunch of keys, charms, loyalty cards, and lanyards on my set to prevent that. Not a good idea. When your key ring is too heavy, it has more than about 5 keys on it, it's bad for your car's ignition. The weight wears down the internal parts, and your vehicle might start missing. One more problem with locks is that not everyone changes them when they move to a new place. Big mistake. If you ever feel you've been compromised, maybe you left your keys in the lock outside, forgot them somewhere, etc., change the locks with no regrets. Now the chances of you coming home from work, going to bed, and your house being broken into are pretty slim. Most burglars will stake your place out for at least a week or two. They'll get to know your routine, work schedule, If you come home for lunch, any alarm systems, pets, or motion-detecting outdoor lights you have, or don't, and so on. No burglar wants to get caught, so they do their deeds when homeowners and any potential eyewitnesses are at work. Peak time for break-ins is from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. Get this! Statistics show that it's often someone who lives nearby and has had plenty of time to memorize your habits. Could even be an acquaintance who's been inside your house before. 65% of burglars know the person whose house they've robbed. Let's say you've had some building work done in your home. After the company completes the project, the workers take their equipment and leave. A few days later, someone in a similar uniform shows up, claiming part of the job wasn't finished properly and needs to be redone. That's a red flag. It could be someone trying to look inside your house. In this scenario, don't let them in. Contact the company you hired first. Same goes for strangers claiming to work for your utilities provider. You might notice a strange vehicle parked in different spots along your street. It may show up during the day, stay in the same place for a few hours, and then take off. If it has tinted windows, then you should be suspicious of it. A car like this is the best cover for street lurkers, since you can't see inside of them. They might also have no license plates or use false ones. If you spot them, don't go up to them or indicate that you've noticed them. Act casual and go back inside. If it happens frequently enough, it's time to raise your suspicions. When you notice someone repeatedly walking up and down your street checking out houses, they could be up to no good, like looking for entry points, such as unlocked windows, slightly open doors, or anything that will give them access to your house. Remember, the most common time for break-ins is between 10 a.m. and 3 p.m. when most people are at work. Someone intending to break into your home may put random flyers or stickers on different houses in your street. This is their way of marking places to see which ones are guarded and which ones aren't. If you're at home, you'll naturally want to throw the stickers out. But if you're not and the stickers get left there, then it's a sign for them. House watchers may draw indirect signs near your house. It could be on the sidewalk or a lamppost. Organized groups use specific codes when drawing their markings. X means that the house is a good target. The open book shows that a vulnerable occupant lives there. Five circles making a flower indicates a wealthy home. An X inside a circle means it's not worth taking anything from there. It could be a gate often left open. Trash in your yard like chocolate wrappers or juice boxes. Watchers usually assume that if you're in, you'll close the gate and pick up the trash. But it's not just that. They might be moving some of your plant pots around to make a blind spot. That way, they can get in at night without anyone seeing them. Some might even throw rocks at the pavement to see if you have a dog or if your pet can hear the noise in the front yard.
One of the most popular things burglars are doing nowadays is tying a thread on the front door handle and fixing it to the nearby wall or door frame. This thread is so thin that a casual onlooker won't even notice it. Some criminals even take extra precaution and use a long strand of hair. By examining the thread, burglars can figure out the pattern of your life. It may reveal to them when you leave for work, go to the gym, head out for a weekend getaway, and of course, when you come back home. With this information in hand, they can plan the perfect break-in. Another trick they use that works pretty much the same way is leaving a cookie under the doormat. By checking the cookie regularly, intruders get a good idea on your whereabouts. If it's crush, you're at home or have been there recently. But if the cookie is still intact, you're probably away on a trip. The same goes for sticking a match into a crevice of your door. If it's fallen or disappeared, you've opened your door. But if the match is still there, you haven't been home. And that's a green light for the bad guys. So, now that you know about some of the tricks offenders have up their sleeves, remember to always check the area around your front door, paying particular attention to the places mentioned so far. But what else can you do to protect yourself from a break-in? Well, being aware of the facts is a good place to start. Over 2 million home invasions are reported in the US every year, but don't forget that some people don't go to the police. This means that the number of burglaries is probably even higher. Homes that don't have any security system are 300% more likely to be invaded. At the same time, only 17% of American homes actually have some kind of security system installed. 1 out of 3 assaults happen as a result of a break-in. This means that you should care for not only your belongings, but your life as well. 85% of all burglaries are committed by inexperienced or amateur crooks. No, that's not for the better, since these types are more desperate and bold, which makes them even more dangerous. Due to the lack of physical evidence and witnesses, police manage to clear no more than 13% of reported burglaries. The master bedroom is the first place a criminal will target, and in most cases, they'll hit the jackpot. Statistically, people keep their cash, jewelry, and collectibles in this room.
Leave a glass of water on a rug right behind your entrance door, which again opens inward. When someone opens the door, it'll tip the glass over and the water will spill, and the rug will absorb it. If you have a thick wool rug, it's unlikely to get dry anytime soon, and you'll find out that someone was in the house during your absence. If you're going to be away for a couple of days, this method obviously won't work because, well, even the thickest rug will be dry by the time you get back. Leave the front door a bit ajar, clean the door handles, and spray them with invisible UV glowing paint. Since the door has been left open, it won't be a problem for you to get out of your home without touching the painted handles. An unsuspecting invader, on the other hand, is sure to leave hand or fingerprints on the door handles. When you get home, you'll be able to see these prints under UV light. To scare burglars away, put alarm signs on all your windows and doors. I hear you, alarm systems are indeed quite expensive. On top of their own price and cost of installation, you'll also have to pay a service contract fee every month. But I didn't say you need an alarm system. I was talking about the stickers. You know, those signs that read, "Protected by so-and-so alarms." If you manage to get hold of such a sticker, put it somewhere where it won't look too obvious, but will still be noticeable. Now, most break-ins occur in the afternoon, when people are at work or at school. Burglars feel safe because their chances of getting caught or identified are low. Still, before getting inside, they watch houses for some time to figure out if they're empty. One of the things they pay attention to is cars parked in driveways. In most cases, it means it's someone's home. If you have an old vehicle you haven't gotten rid of yet, make it useful. Park it in the driveway to fend off thieves. Or if your family member isn't using their car, don't hide it in the garage. Leave it outside. One day, you might get a distinct feeling that your home is being cased or watched by burglars. Maybe a stranger comes up to your front or back door and tries the handle. By the way, never open it from the get-go. Keep it closed, but ask how you can help from the other side. They'll probably make up some excuse about mistaking your house for someone else's and then leave. Anyway, if you're short of money and don't want to deal with all the security camera technicalities, install fake ones. They're pretty simple to create on your own, like from old webcams. Or, if you suspect that a burglar is casing your house, you can pretend someone's inside at all times. When you leave, wave and say your goodbyes to some non-existent person inside. Hey, I'll be happy to be your non-existent person. Oh wait, I do exist. Never mind. If a burglar is watching, they won't know you're just talking to your couch. If you're out of town in the winter, ask your neighbors to leave some tire tracks in your driveway when it snows. An untouched layer of snow is a sure way to inform burglars that the homeowners haven't been there for some time. Obviously, you can't be home 24/7. That's why you need some extra eyes on your house for when you're away. So, get on friendly terms with those who live around you. Let them know your schedule, habits, or routine. For example, let's say you always leave the light on in the upstairs bathroom. That way, if anything is wrong or suspicious is happening in or around your house, perhaps your bathroom light is switched off, your neighbors will notice it. Now, this tip might seem pretty obvious when it comes to keeping your home burglar-free, but it's important to mention. Showing off your costly stuff doesn't do you any good. If anything, it only gives ideas to shady people. If you have a shed or garage, tuck your expensive equipment in there once you're done using it. Otherwise, you might one day find yourself one lawnmower short. Your home could be a full-on fortress, fit with high-end safety technology and state-of-the-art door and window locks. But if you carelessly left a ladder outside for the day, you could come back from work only to find that your house has been robbed because you forgot to protect your chimney. A toolbox left out in the open also looks like an invitation to break and enter. A flash of bright light in the dark of night may help you kill two birds with one stone. By the way, that's just an expression. No animals were harmed in the making of this video. Now, sudden bright lights will disorient the criminal for a few moments and give you a heads up that something's going on in or around your house. Yep, you heard that right. Motion sensor light fittings are better installed both outside and inside your home. While putting them outside is pretty obvious, installing some in your house gives you a huge advantage. You know that your rooms will get lit up when you enter them. Burglars, however, have no clue. In more ways than one. If you leave a large pair of work boots on your porch, they'll get a potential burglar thinking that there's someone home at the moment. Plus, big boots make it look like a big guy lives there. Not many criminals would risk getting caught and beat up by some huge dude. No sir. You know your home better than anyone, so you can probably get around it even in pitch dark. Burglars will be much more careful when going about their business, so you'll have an advantage here. Avoid using a flashlight, too. It'll give away your position. As much as you may love lavishness, you'd better at least keep it away from prying eyes. Burglars have a good eye for valuable items. If you put your money, time, and effort into decorating your front yard, for example, it's likely that you do the same thing for the inside of your house. Keep the front lawn as simple as possible. It'll save you from unwanted attention.